Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika and in this video I'm going to talk about the new Intertwine feature in Illustrator. So let's first take a look at how it works. I'm going to select all of these elements and I want to change the stacking order of the segments where they intertwine so that it really looks like a tight knot. To do that, I'm going to Object, Intertwine, Make. And once you have made the intertwine, you have to set up the stacking order of those segments. And to do that, you get this lasso cursor. And the lasso cursor is not to be mistaken for the lasso we have in the tool panel. We are going to take a look at that later. And in order to change the stacking order, you just surround it like so, and Illustrator changes the order. And when we get to this one here, then at first nothing happens. And when you roll over, you see these highlights and you have to select the one you want to change. So there are more than two, so Illustrator doesn't know what to do. So we have to click on it with the right mouse button and say, okay, I want to bring that to the front. And then there's no other highlight. So if I want to also bring this one to the back, that wouldn't work with the selection I have chosen before. So to do that, it would have been better to select them one by one because Illustrator doesn't recognize the single intersections, but it just takes for granted what you select with that lasso. So what we can do afterwards would be to go round here as well, and then it changes this. But there's something wrong with that approach, and let's take a look at a different approach. So I'm going around here, I want to change that, and I'm going to make a mistake. So this has been wrong. You see the intersection is wrong, and with this one you also see Illustrator has no intelligent approach to this. It just follows your selection. So this is wrong. And in order to correct that, we need to undo it. So we go to Edit, Undo. And now we are out of this. So it doesn't work if we just go to the lasso tool because it doesn't work on this. You see, it just selects. And in order to select, in order to edit this again, you need to select it. And you see this is a live object. Is this an intertwine? And you go to Object, Intertwine, Edit. And then we can do this one again. And this one, this time it's okay. So I'm going here as well. So that's nice. And when we are done, we can just deselect it and then this is set up. You cannot later edit the masks that you have drawn. So they are really masks. We are going to take a look at that later as well, but you can do edits. So you can, with a direct selection tool, edit one of the paths and you see, you move them around and there has been a rearrangement, but Illustrator doesn't follow along with the new crossing. So you can edit it, but only in some narrow possibilities. What you can also do is select this and apply an effect. So let's apply a drop shadow to that. And you see again at this place here, it doesn't work because the drop shadow spills through that mask. And again, Illustrator doesn't follow that. And we have the same situation here. So we've also got a situation there. This doesn't look right. Let's take a look at what Illustrator does. And we're going to return to this one later, but I've prepared one here. So these dashed lines I will draw as masks. So let's again select this, go to Object, Intertwine, and Make. And there we have the lasso, and I'm going to follow these as precise as I can. So let's go around here, and they don't make any sense. I just want to use them to demonstrate how this works, like so. Again, we have to select what we want to change. So I want to bring this to the front, like so. And let's make the next one here. And again, it doesn't make any sense to draw the mask this way, like so. And again, we are going to change this one and bring it to front, like so. And now this is a live object. We can take a look at it in the layers panel, and you see there we have the two intertwines and they contain the paths. This is a container object and it's live. And in order to expand it to see how this really works, what Illustrator does inside, we go to Object, Expand. And there we can expand this thing and we can see what Illustrator has done. So in the layers panel, you see this is now a group. It's no longer live. It's no longer an intertwine. And there we have what's inside. And you see Illustrator created several clipping masks. Let's make this broader. You see these are clip groups, clipping paths. And one is a compound clipping paths. And all the base objects have been duplicated and are now inside the clipping path. And in this case, this one down here, Illustrator has changed the stacking order because we have changed it when working with that lasso tool. So Illustrator has changed it and has made all these clip groups. So let's take a look at them. I'm going to select this one and you see it's the clip group. This one is the compound clip group and there are the paths. And let's move this to the side. So I'm going to undo that. We first have to ungroup it once, like so. And now we can take it apart. And you see, this is what Illustrator has done. So it's put all of these into clipping masks. And the clipping masks have exactly the shapes I have drawn with the lasso. No intelligence included in this. And it's just changed the stacking order. And the same, of course, has happened with this one. But there we have got this one where I have made the correction to the mask. So let's expand it as well. And yes, it cannot be expanded because there is the shadow. So we first have to expand appearance and then we can expand the object like so. And again, we get these clip groups down here, and there are slightly more of them because I have changed a lot of stackings in this one. So let's ungroup that. And you see, this is the place where I had to edit because I first made this one, this mask, and then I changed my mind and had to make the other one as well. And in that case, Illustrator actually made two masks, this one and then this one. And there are these lines and they happen because of the shadow and there's some imprecision included. So with the added complexity of that shadow, it might not work in the end, at least not when you expand it. So that's how the intertwine feature works inside. I still like that feature. It's a great feature because it allows you to be intuitive and just make these masks. Only when you clean up this, you have to be careful. And I'm expecting a lot of improvement on this feature. And I think it will get great. If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.